We about to dress the culture. Go tell a friend. We about to dress the culture.
Drink, stop, drink to get your boy Big Wall, and this is Address the Culture. And today we back with another exciting episode. We got a special guest in the building now. When we talk about hit makers, legendary producers, you know what I'm talking about? This guy we got on coming through the culture today, he fits the bill. You know what I'm saying? He done worked with the likes of Keisha Cole, Miguel, Breeze, Jacquees, Amari Hardwick, Ghost, if you don't know, you know what I'm saying? Just the name of few, you know what I'm talking about? This is what you call a billboard producer. We got the one. We got the only. We got Major League Beats in the building, man. Welcome to Address the Culture.
What up, what up, what up, y'all?
You already know, bro. It's dope to have somebody like you come through the culture, man, because, you know, and this game ain't no flowers, man. You know what I'm saying? It's hard times and bubble guns, bro. And somebody like you with your story and the success that you done had in the game, it's motivation. You know what I'm saying? It's good for people to see that you can make it. No matter how hard it is, you can, man. So I appreciate your time, bro.
Man, I appreciate y'all for having me, bro. For sure.
Man, you already know, man. So with all that being said, the first thing I want to know is, how did you get your name?
I played baseball like my whole life. So when I started producing, I was like real green to it. So I was like, man, I don't know. Major League Beats. You know what I'm saying? It just made sense. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Like,
Major League Baseball, Major League Beats. Yeah. Let's do it.
Yeah. Hey, look, when it work, it work. You know what I'm saying? Because let's be honest. Everything you do is Major League. You know what I'm talking about? You know what I'm saying? So, you know, we just gonna call a spade, man. You know what I'm saying? So, with that being said, who is Major League Beats?
Man, just a young baseball player who always loved music and just blessed to be here, man. That's just, I can't put it no other way, bro.
Yeah, man. That's dope, bro. And the music that you do, man, it's at a real high level, man. Your sounds, the way you put it together, man. I've had the opportunity to listen through some of your beats, man, and it's definitely at a high level, man. So shout out to you, bro.
I appreciate that,
man. No doubt, bro. It's just a fact. How did you get your first start into music?
Man, I was playing baseball in college. I got picked up by a pro team and played in the winter out in Arizona and ended up tearing my rotator's cuff. And they was like, it's been really torn for years. You know what I mean? Like, we don't know how you played through the pain. But I had surgery and they was like, you might come back, but you don't have no tissue or cartilage between here.
Yeah.
And basically, long story short, it was just over with. And I always played keys, though. Even while I played baseball, I was always the guy with some type of small little keyboard or something in my hotel room or whatever it may be, even in college. And I ended up getting hired on at Guitar Center, which was wild, because when I filled out the application, I'm like, bro, ain't no way to, you know what I'm saying, you get on here. Like, you know, that's right. Like a dream job for a music person, you know what I mean?
That's a
like,
fact.
I'm not getting this job, bro. And I ended up getting it, like, getting on at a brand new store out here in Houston. And then they, I opened up the store with the company and with a whole new team, a whole new staff, and ended up being a manager up there. And at work, I used to just play around on the keyboards, basically, because it would kind of be slow.
Yeah.
And one of my coworkers, I was making a beat on the keyboard. He was like, bro, you should get you a Mac, you know what I mean, and get you Logic, you know, and just start making beats. And I was like, bro, I don't know nothing about none of that. Like, mind you, I'm like 24, 25 at the time, and I didn't know what a music producer was, you know what I mean? Like, and so he was like, nah. And so, you know, we have the little setup stands at Guitar Center, you know, with keyboards. And he showed me how to work Logic, and like, next paycheck, I was like, I got to get one of these, like. Because, you know, everything is quantized, everything, you can sync everything together, and I could never do that on a keyboard. So I end up getting a MacBook and Logic, and the rest is history. Like,
oh Man, dope. That's dope. Hey, well, shout out to your coworker, man. You know what I'm saying? Man.
For real, for real. I had no idea what this was. You know, you would always hear like Kanye's a producer or Timbaland's a producer, yeah. Da, 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 but I had no idea exactly what the producer did, you know? So.
Yeah. Hey, man, that's dope, bro. That's one of them stories, man, that the coaches need to hear, you know what I'm saying? Because, like, again, it's just the truth. Like, your sound, man, it's definitely next level, man. And to know you started off just by playing keys and it just led into you making them beats, man. You never know, bro. You never know. That's super dope. Who inspires you to make the music that you make?
I get asked this question a lot. It's not really just one person or even a few producers, because like I said, I was late to know what a producer was.
Yeah.
But I was just an R&B kid, like, even as a kid. Like, when people was listening to probably like Pac, Biggie, Jay-Z early on, I was listening to like Bone Thugs,
yeah,
Faith Evans, Brian McKnight, Casey and JoJo. Like,
yeah,
that type of music just for some reason just resonated with me really, really well.
Yeah.
And when I started making beats, it was more like R&B stuff. Like, I could always kind of put a hip hop feel to it, you know, and kind of cross the platforms. But just R&B was just my vibe. Like, I just,
yeah,
everything in that era, like, it just 90s R&B, you know, Jagged Edge and stuff like that, Drew Hill.
Yeah.
That's what I was into, so real heavy, so.
Yeah. That's dope, man. That's super dope, because, like, for me, you know, R&B is definitely one of my favorite genres, you know what I mean? And I could be a little biased, but that 90s R&B had a sound and a vibe to me that's just unmatched. You know what I mean? Absolutely. Yeah, bro. And yo beats, bro. It's like it gives you that with the new twist, but it gives you that nostalgic feeling. You know what I mean? Like, and that's what it's all about, bro. Like, so you put the right lyric on your track, man. No wonder you got so many hits, bro. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, man. That's a fact, bro. How would you describe the music that you create?
It's just heartfelt. Like, I say this a lot on Instagram under my posts a lot of times. If it don't hit the heart when I make it, it's not, y'all never gonna hear it. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, if the music just doesn't say something without a lyric on it, then the record just ain't for me. You know what I mean? Like, so,
yeah.
It's just really heartfelt. Even if it's rap or, you know, something up-tempo, it's still gonna be something in there that just makes you connect with it. Like, yo,
yeah,
I feel something when I hear this.
Yeah, that's dope, man. It take you back to that nostalgia. You know what I'm saying? Like, it got to have that feel. Like, when you hear a Jodeci track drop or a Drew Hill or a Jagged Edge, like, it takes you right back to the first time you heard it, and it give you that feeling. If your mama was in the kitchen cooking up some biscuits, you gonna smell them biscuits when you hear that song, you know what I'm saying?
Absolutely, like, absolutely.
Yeah, and that's exactly what your music do, bro. When you get in the lab, bro, what's your creative process like?
Man, I'm normally in here alone. I have one intern that's in here with me. It's normally just lights off, like same vibe as in here right now.
Yeah.
AC on, I like to be cool.
Yeah,
and just, you know, I ain't no small dude, so
I'm with you.
Had an AC on, like,
that's a fact.
I gotta have an AC on, and then
I'm with you, dog.
That's just it. Typically, some water, you know what I mean, and just vibe out. A lot of times when I first get in the lab, I just listen to music. Like, I would just listen to random music, different genres and stuff, all kind of stuff, and then, you know, I probably just be looking around on my phone real quick. And then it's like, all right, let's get it. And I just tap in.
Yeah, that's dope. It's all about setting the vibe, man. The vibe got to be right, man. I understand what you're talking about, man. It just comes out in the music. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
You done work with so many artists in the game. You know what I'm saying? But who would you most likely hear yourself collabing with? With like today's artists. You know what I mean? With your sound. who would you like? Yeah, I would want to hear your vocals on my beats.
I'm gonna say this one, and I'm sure you've probably gotten this one 10 times. I'ma say Drake, but here's the thing.
Okay.
Here's the thing. You know, we all want the Drake record for sure.
That's a fact.
We all want the Drake record. But I want a certain type of Drake record, and only this one. I don't want none of the radio Drake joints.
Okay.
I want the Do Not Disturb, 3 a.m. I'm 7:30, Western Road Flows.
Yeah.
The like those type of records where it's just like he just did the Lemon Pepper Freestyle.
Yeah.
One of those type of records. You know what
Talk
I mean?
Talk your like, shit.
I want one of those records.
Yeah. Because
to me, like, that's when Drake's being Drake. You know what I mean? Like,
bad.
Like, that's when you get that So Far Gone Drake from Drake.
Ooh, talk your shit, man.
You know
talk
what I mean?
Your
like,
shit. Yeah.
I like that Drake. I mean, he's amazing. You know, he puts out tons of hit records. That's cool.
Yeah.
But you get Aubrey, you get on those records. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I want to do one of those with Drake, and I believe it's going to happen.
Bro, that'd be crazy. It's funny that you said the So Far Gone Drake, the Lemon Pepper Drake. You know what I'm saying? I recently did a reaction to it, man. And that Lemon Pepper is crazy. And with your productions, with Trey and that bag, oh, we got a problem. We got another billboard.
Yeah.
We got a...
For sure. I got to get 30 of them sitting in the catalog right now.
Loading up the chamber. We ready.
Right now. Let's do it.
Yeah, let's go. That's what's up, bro. When we talk about placements, you know what I mean? As a major league producer, pun intended, you know what I'm saying? When we talk about that word placements, man, a lot of people either don't understand what it is or don't know how important it is. You know what I mean? We got a lot of producers out here in this world, but we ain't got a lot of producers getting placements.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? So when we talk about that, can you tell me how important it is to get those placements and how would an up-and-coming producer go about getting those placements?
Man, I'm going to be completely honest, bro. Just put out dope music. Not one placement that I have, not a single one was done for me like through a connect, through an email, through a favor. Bro, like it's all been organic. Like somebody's ran across my YouTube and be like, hey, bro, you hard, let's work. Jacquees just jumped on one of my joints from YouTube. Breezy, that started from a record that she took from my YouTube, and I just jumped in her DM and was like, hey, you know, thanks for using my beat. And she was like, yo, send me some more shit. Long story short, I got over 50 records with Bree. You know,
man.
And been in LA in her crib 5-6 times. You know what I mean? Ghost from Power. We just started working last week. He ran across my YouTube, hit me in the DM. No, matter of fact, he commented on my YouTube. And I was like, all right, bro, if it's really you, thanks for checking out. Like, you know, whatever, bro.
Right, all right.
Yeah, all right, bro. You know what I'm saying? So, bro, email me. Like, literally, bro, email me. And was
yo.
Like, it's me.
It's me. It's really Ghost. You know what I'm talking about?
And he sent me like two emails. He said it's me. He said something else in there. And then in the second email, I watched his interviews. You know what I mean? So
yeah.
I could tell by the lingo. I was like, either whoever this is playing with me is a great actor, you know what I mean? Or something, you know what I mean? And then like So I kind of pulled the card. I normally don't do this with celebs. I kind of pulled the card and was like, hey, you know, it'd be cool, you know what I'm saying? We could FaceTime or something, you know. And I sent my number and bro called me and was like, hey, what up? You know, good morning, King. Da, 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 da. I was like, oh shit, this is Ghost, bro. Like, like I low key lost my shit real quick. I was like, oh, shit. You know what I'm saying? This really is, bro. And yo. I mean, bro, this was probably Friday of last week, Thursday of last week, or something like that. And bro, we got three records completed already. He's dropped one. His last post on his Instagram is the one I produced for him. And we got some other joints. I mean, I did a record with Keisha. I did four records with Keisha Cole a few years ago, back from responding to a tweet and was like, damn, I hate you, change your album in. You know what I'm saying? I had some records for it. Clearly, she not going to hit me back, right?
Yeah, of course not.
Motherfucker, she get that all day. Motherfucker hit me back, DM me the email, boom, 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 boom. 2 o'clock in the morning, I get a phone call from this random-ass number. Looked like an operator number, but it was 2 a.m, so I'm like, what the fuck going on here? I answer. I answer, bro. It's like, hey, what's the key of this beat? Like, bro, this Keisha for real? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's just, bro, it's just been blessings, bro. It just come from really just working. Like, every opportunity, bro, has come from just working. The Miguel record, just did that in October, November. Should be on the upcoming project. That just came from just working. You know what I'm saying? Me and Tone P, Wale's producer, did all of the hits for Wale back in the gap. We just worked on a record. And, like, we got a lot of records now together. And he found me through Instagram as well, you know? So everything has just been organic, bro. Like, it's like, I never chased the placement, and they've just seemed to kind of fall in my lap from just staying consistent. I mean, I'm in the lab working every day. And like, I would just tell any other producer, bro, just create the best music you can, continue to grow, continue to learn. And you know, bro, it'll happen for you.
Man, that's dope, man. But look, dog, I'm not finna hold you. You getting your flowers today, big dog. You know what I'm talking about? I see why they calling you, dog. Like, yo, beats, bro. Like I do this music. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And I hear a lot of beats, man. You know what I'm saying? And, bruh, your beats is something different, dog. They should be calling you. They smart. They smart. You know what I'm talking about? Because it's for somebody that's creative and somebody that got that in them, when you get a start like your tracks, bruh, it makes it so easy. Like, the lyric come effortless. Like, that's the best music to make, when you don't have to sit down and force it and try to make it work, when you could just let the beat go and just you come up with lyrics before you even finish listening to the track. And that's the type of time your beat's on, man. So I see why they reaching out to you. You know what I'm talking about? That's a fact, y'all. That's a fact.
I appreciate it.
Yeah, man, that's real talk, man. So what we gonna do now, we gonna take a break for our sponsors, you know what I'm saying? Shout out the Networking Queen. Shout out DJ Domino, the official DJ for Address the Culture. The Big Gas Tour, moving to a city near you. And we'll be right back with the boy, Major League Beats, to Address the Culture. You feel me?
Yeah, yo.
Check out that fire, Gucci, Fendi, yaya. Counting up this motherfucking money in the sauna. If we step around, it's guaranteed that you can find us. Everybody running on and holding up their lighters. I got that fire, Gucci, Fendi, yaya. Counting up this motherfucking money in the sauna. If we step around, it's guaranteed that you can find us. Everybody running on and holding up their lighters. Hold a drink in my dub cup.
You already know what it is. You already know what it is. It's your boy Big Wall, and we back to Address the Culture with the big dog, Major League Beats, in the building. Now,
yo.
We're gonna turn it up a little bit, bro. You know what I'm saying? Get a little spicy around this part of the interview. You know what I'm saying? I want to get into your psyche a little bit. You know what I'm saying? If you could share the stage and work and make a beat and bring any artist, dead or alive, to the major league experience. You know what I'm saying? Where you can just do whatever you want to do, make whatever kind of records you want to do. They're fully under your control. You know what I'm talking about? Any artist, dead or alive, which artist would you work with?
I ain't never been asked this question either. That's a good one.
Yeah, that's what we do.
That's a great one. that's a good one. I'd probably say Michael Jackson solely because of his versatility. Like, we could do so much. Like, you know, like, I like working on things that are just musically, we can kind of go any direction. Yeah. A lot of times in sound now, there's this box that you kind of got to stay in a little bit. Like, yeah. Oh, we're going to do drill. Oh, we're going to do Summer Walker R&B.
Yeah.
We're going to do Jacquees R&B.
Yeah.
You know, we're going to do this type of trap or this type of Ariana Grande pop type record. I think with Mike, bro, we could just get in. I just play some chords and the rest is history after that. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
It can go anywhere, any type of way. So,
hey, bro. That's scary. That's scary. Hey, Mike on your tracks, dog. Mike don't feel us. I mean, bro, this is not gas, bro. You know what I'm saying? Your beats, they dope, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, I get it. Hey, Mike, that's dope. I like your ear, your sound. Like, you, when it comes to the R&B, and correct me if I'm wrong, it sound like you like really with the musical kind of people. Like, the people who, like, really in tune with it, your Michael Jacksons, your R. Kellys, your Chris Browns, your Beyoncés, like people who like serious about this music thing. You know what I'm saying? Like you kind of like match them, but on the production side. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, absolutely. I appreciate that for real.
Yeah. That's dope, bro. Now we both know in this game, the internet is a big part of it. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people say it's smoke and mirrors, it's a gift and a curse. But through your viewpoint, how do you feel the internet has impacted the music industry?
I mean, I'm going to say this from a producer standpoint. Man, it's just crazy. It's a goddamn, excuse my language, but it's a flood of opportunity. Like, I mean, you can sit around and sit all day and say, oh, it's oversaturated, it's too many people doing this, it's da 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 da. Bro, find your lane and go get it. I mean, it's so much money out here to be made, and it's so many ways to make yourself visible now with the internet, whether it be YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, Facebook, whatever it may be. I mean, you got people becoming millionaires every day off of social media. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Off of like these streaming platforms. And you know, the fact that, bro, you can record your album at the crib and you be on iTunes in 2 weeks is crazy. You know
That's
what I mean? Like, it's crazy. You know what I mean? Like, it's just so much opportunity with the internet. Like, you know, back in the days, you couldn't be a producer or artist without a studio.
Yeah.
Nowadays, bro, you can have your own studio at the crib. You know what I mean? Like, record and drop your own music from the crib, you know.
Yeah. So
it just creates a whole lot of opportunity, and I think if you look at it that way and take advantage of it, you know, you'll be very successful with it.
Yeah, that's dope, man. Coming through the culture, dropping jewels. You know what I'm talking about? I like that. You know what I'm saying? When you think back along your career, bro, what was some of the best advice you've ever been given?
Just stay consistent. Like, I mean, I think all of my blessings has come from just being consistent. I mean, on my YouTube, I have over 500 beats. And today, I still sell beats from 2017, 2016, 2018. You know, just that consistency is key. Like, people might not catch on or even pay attention in the beginning.
Yeah.
But when by the time people catch up with whatever you got going, your back catalog is still there.
Yeah.
So everything that they wasn't paying attention to, now they want to go back there and see what was done back there too.
Yeah, so that's a fact.
I mean, I literally sell more beats from 2017, 2018, 2019 than I sell from everyday, day-to-day stuff. So.
Yeah. That's dope, man. I definitely can relate, man. It's all about the work. It's all about the consistency, man. That's super dope. If you could change something about the game, what would you change?
Man, I don't know. It's funny because, you know, just in conversations in the studio with your homeboys, you be complaining about all kind of shit.
Yeah. All day, every day.
All day, every day. But I can't think of nothing off of, you know, just the top of my head. But maybe we'll come back to that one. I'll definitely think of something.
All right. You know, we're going to tap back in. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I like that. My that's what my questions do, man. We here to address the culture. You know what I'm talking about?
That was definitely a good one.
All right, my man. If you could go back and give younger you some advice, what would you tell yourself?
Be patient. I know at some points, you know what I mean? Like, I was like, oh, damn, you know, maybe I never get a placement, or maybe this isn't dope enough, or whatever it is. Yeah. And, you know, shit. I mean, look at where we at now. You know, just be patient. And, you know, like I said, stay consistent. Like, the consistency is really what's kind of paid off in the long run. Like, so.
Yeah. That's dope. No, go ahead.
No, I was just saying, be patient, you know, and stay consistent.
What would you like to say to all your supporters, man? All the people that's been in your corners, the A1s, the day ones, even before you started making the music, back when you was playing baseball. What would you like to say to them, bro?
I just appreciate y'all for believing in me and just rocking with me. From people from back then, even to people daily now, I mean, people hit me all the time, bro, I'm so proud of you. And, you know, like, it's crazy where you at. And sometimes to myself, it's like, I don't even be believing some of this shit sometimes. You know what I mean? Like, I be living in it. My boy C-Max is sitting right next to me, and he's in the lab with me every day.
Yeah.
And we was talking the other night on the phone, and I was like, bro, this shit is kind of like a dream sometimes. You know what I mean? Like, bro, you sitting here, you know, chilling, and ghost texting you, or you in L.A. at Bree Crib, and you... It's like, damn, bro, how we even get here? You know what I mean? Like, so I appreciate everybody who believes in me, people who still rock with me and believe in me now. And I appreciate it. Like, I mean, humbled in the most way. Like, this shit is as dreamy as it is to y'all, to me.
Yeah. Gotta pinch yourself sometime. Like, man, it's crazy. You know what I'm talking about?
Man, it is wild sometimes. Yeah.
That's dope, man. So we gonna do this for them. You know what I'm saying? I call it doing it for the culture, rapid fire. I'm gonna ask you some quick questions that gives your fans, your supporters, a little bit more insight on who you are as a man on a day-to-day basis. You down?
I'm down. Let's go.
All right, let's get it. The first thing I do or think when I wake up in the morning is?
Brush my teeth, of course.
Hot or cold?
Hot.
Favorite restaurant?
Del Frisco's.
Chicken, steak, or fish?
Fish.
Favorite pair of shoes of all times?
Jordan 11 Breads.
If you were stuck on the desert island for a year and could only take three albums with you, which albums you take?
Graffiti, Chris Brown, Drake's third to second to last album.
Okay.
And my Poetry of a Beats album.
Alright, talk your shit. favorite drink?
Crown Vanilla.
Alright, I fuck with the Crown Apple, but I see what type of time you are. You know what I'm talking about? That's a fact. Favorite sports team?
Houston Astros.
Okay, weekends or weekdays?
Weekdays for work.
All right. How many times a day do you think about sex?
Three to five times.
I get it, bro. I'm right with you. We focus, baby. We in the lab. You know what I'm talking about? That's a fact. If you could have one superpower, what would it be?
Read other people's minds.
Okay, I see what you on over there. Mad shit. All right, I see what type of time you all. Okay, I'm going to start the sentence, and I want you to finish it for me, okay?
Okay.
My name is Major League Beats, and I am a...
music producer.
Big dog shit. You know what I'm talking about? My man, tell me what's next for you, bro. What you got going on, bro? What's up on the roster, bro?
Man, waiting on Breezy's project to drop. I mean, yeah. We got over 50 in the bag for sure and still doing some stuff every day. Me and Ghost just did one. It just dropped on his Instagram. I just did another one for him today. We talking about doing a project soon. So definitely be on the lookout for that. And a lot of stuff I always like to mention the indie artists I work with more so than the major people because yeah. I feel like they need the promotion more so. So yeah. Shout out my boy C-Max is in here with me daily. We got a lot of stuff coming with him. Oh. I just did a record for Lafayette Taylor. That's out right now. Got a couple joints with him. Shout out to my girl, Nicole Lundy. And everybody else, if I forgot you, y'all know we working today. I got y'all. But everybody know I love
you. Yeah, man. That's what it is, bro. Now, what you want us to play at the end, man? What beat? What song, whatever you want us to play at the end of this interview to further let them know what type of time you on. You know what I'm saying? What you want us to play, man?
I'll tell you what you can play. You can pick your favorite beat off my YouTube and you play that.
All right. I'm going to take you up on that. You know what I'm talking about? That's a fact, bro. And that's what we own, man. I want to thank you for coming through, Address the Culture, man, giving us your energy. Dropping jewels all over the culture, man. I appreciate your time, man. It was super dope, man. Consider this your home away from home. Anytime you got anything coming out, anything you want to talk about, man, we come through, we talk about it, we make it a movie, man. I appreciate you.
Man, I appreciate y'all having me, bro. Thank you to all the listeners on here. Like, I'm humbled to even be on here, man. I appreciate y'all so much.
Man, no doubt, bro. We locked in, man. This is your boy, Big Wall, and this is Address the Culture. And like I always say, your culture makes you who you are, so make sure to respect it. We're going to catch you on the next episode. We out of here.
Out.
Dope, bro. Appreciate your time, man. Appreciate your time, brother.
I appreciate you for having me, bro. That was crazy. You dope as fuck with the questions as well, bro. Yeah, that's probably one of the best interviews, bro, I've had. Like, for real, for real.
Oh man, bro, thank you, man. That means a lot, man. I'm humble, man. I'm working like you working over there, bro. You know what I'm talking about?
I appreciate it, bro.
That's a fact, bro. You'll give me a drop?
Yeah. What you want me to say?
Major League Beats. I just did my interview with Big Wall. If you ain't never get an interview with Big Wall, get one. Get in tune. Address the coach. You know, talk to you.
Okay, Major League Beats. I'm with who? Say it again.
Big Wall and Address the Culture. If you ain't got an interview with Big Wall, you need to get one. You know what I'm saying? So on and so forth. You know what I mean?
Okay. You ready?
Yep.
Yo, what up? It's your boy, Major League Beats. I'm with my boy, Brick Wall and Address the Culture. If you ain't tapped in and got an interview yet, you better get one. Let's go. H-Town in the building.
My man, I appreciate you, bro. I'm going to hit you when we get off here because I want to talk to you about some things. You know what I'm saying? But I'm going to call you in a second, bro.
All right, man. Talk to you in a little bit.
My man. Appreciate you.
No problem. Appreciate y'all. Yeah. Bye-bye.
shine.